everyone, and welcome back to Upside Down Disney. If you're new here, my name is Jess, and Merry Christmas Eve if you are celebrating, and Merry Vlogmas Day 24. This is the last day of Vlogmas, and the last video that I will be posting for Vlogmas slash the holidays. I will not be posting a video on Christmas Day, just because I want Christmas Day to be a day to relax and kind of just not have to worry about anything. So I will not be posting Christmas Day. I know some people are continuing Vlogmas to like a 25th day, but I'm just doing it as like a countdown to Christmas. And so we are at day 24. And so this will be the last Vlogmas video. So with that said, for the last day of Vlogmas, I wanted to go over my top 10 favorite Disney ornaments. I have a pretty extensive collection of ornaments, and a lot of them are Disney related. And so I just wanted to kind of share some of my favorites, because ornaments and decorating for the holidays are definitely some of my favorite things and some of the things that are most special to me and like some of the memories that I really savor the most. So I thought it would be fun. I've seen some other people do their ornament collections or like their favorite ornaments, and I've loved seeing what other people have and what's kind of special and sentimental to other people and for what reasons. So yeah, I am super excited to show you all the ornaments that I chose, and stay tuned for the end of the video because we will be opening the final day of our Funko Pocket Pop advent calendar. So I'm excited to see who we get for the final day. I have a guess as to who it might be, but I will save that for the end. So yeah, without further ado, here are some of my favorite Disney themed ornaments. They're not in any particular order. I'm just gonna kind of show them as I grab them. But yeah, so to start off with is actually gonna be one that I'm not gonna show you like physically in my hand, but I'm gonna show you a little clip of it on my Christmas tree. So this is an ornament of Jack Skellington kind of peeking through the door into Christmas Town. So this one I got, gosh, I can't even remember how long ago I got this ornament. It might be an almost like 10 year old ornament at this point. It is from the Hallmark Keepsake collection, and it is just absolutely one of my favorites. It's one of the oldest ones that I have. It was one of the first Nightmare Before Christmas ornaments that I ever got, and Nightmare Before Christmas is like one of my favorite things for Halloween and for Christmas. So I have a whole lot of Nightmare Before Christmas ornaments that I put on my Christmas tree every year, and so this was kind of one of the first and kind of started the whole collection. So yeah, I absolutely love this ornament, and I love that for the door, like for the tree, that you put the little tree light up in the tree and then you can see it kind of like peeking through the door into Christmas Town. So yeah, I absolutely love that detail about it. I think it's just so pretty. Every year I try to put like a different colored light in it, so that it shines through a different color. And I just love Jack's like inquisitive face peeking through the door. And yeah, it's just absolutely, and that's one of my favorite scenes from Nightmare Before Christmas, is the whole transition from Halloween Town into Christmas Town and into What's This. So I absolutely love this ornament, and it's just so special to me for that reason. So next up is a new ornament from this year, and it is the child in his little like pram carriage thing. This one is a Hallmark Keepsake ornament as well. And I have just been absolutely obsessed with the Mandalorian and the child, and so I'm so glad that they made ornaments for it. He is just absolutely adorable. I love that it looks like he's like kind of using the Force. I just think he's so adorable, and I absolutely love this ornament. I think that he looks perfect on it. They did a really good job of, sometimes faces and things can kind of look a little bit messed up, but he just looks so adorable. This is probably one of the cutest Baby Yoda ornaments I've seen as of late. I absolutely love him. He's quickly and easily one of my favorite ornaments, commemorating one of my favorite shows. And Star Wars is just a huge thing in my family in general, so this is just a super cute ornament that makes me think of family. So next up is an ornament from last Christmas, and it is this Little Mermaid 30th anniversary ornament. And it is of the Kiss the Girl scene. So this one I don't really use as a Christmas ornament. I just kind of have it on display all the time, because other than the fact that it has the little like thing to hang it as an ornament, it doesn't look super Christmassy. And it commemorates the 30th anniversary of Little Mermaid, which is my favorite Disney movie, and Ariel is my favorite princess, and the Kiss the Girl scene is just absolutely one of my favorites. I love everything about it. I love Ariel's blue dress. I love the song so much, and so this is just perfect. It has the little 30 icon up there, and yeah, I absolutely love this. My partner and I sing this song to each other all the time, so it definitely makes me think of them, and yeah, it's just a super beautiful ornament. I think that they like nailed their faces sometimes and things like this. Like, I have the big Jim Shore of this scene, and Ariel's face doesn't look the best in it, but I think this ornament perfectly captured both Ariel and Eric's look. and you have little Flounder there blowing out the water, and you have Sebastian sitting up there singing. And then I love how they just made it look like the boat was sitting in water. It's just super pretty. And so this is a display piece all the time, but it is also definitely one of my favorite ornaments. Up next is another Hallmark keepsake ornament, and this one is a Frozen ornament. I think this one's from maybe 2017. So it says on the bottom it is from 2016. So this is a 2016 Hallmark keepsake ornament, and it is Anna and Elsa when they're kids building Olaf. And so this one I just think is so cute. I love the portrayal of Anna and Elsa there, and their dresses and the little details like printed at the bottom are super cute. And then Olaf looks adorable, and then the whole thing is covered in glitter, and it also plays, I think, Do You Want to Build a Snowman? I don't know if the batteries are still gonna work. But let's give it a try.
Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away.
So yeah, it plays Do You Want to Build a Snowman, and it is just super adorable, and I love the relationship between Anna and Elsa, like I said, and I love Do You Want to Build a Snowman as a song. It makes me cry every single time I watch the movie, so yeah, that's absolutely one of my favorite ornaments. Up next is a Mulan ornament. This one I got last year, I believe. Yep, so this one is from 2019, and it is just Mulan in her green dress. And I love these Disney store. This is from the Disney store, and I absolutely love these ornaments where they're kind of just like the full like princesses, and they're in dresses, and there's like actual fabric detail at the bottom of the dress. I think that they're so pretty, and Mulan here just looks absolutely beautiful. And Mulan is one of my favorite Disney movies. It is the first movie I ever saw in theaters, and I saw it with my grandmother, who passed away quite some time ago, so Mulan always makes me think of her. And so I absolutely love this ornament for that reason, and make sure that I put it on my Christmas tree every year now. Up next is an Aristocats ornament. This is another Hallmark keepsake ornament, and I think this is from 2019. Yep, it is from 2019. And this one just features Marie sitting on a pillow. I just absolutely love this one. I think Marie looks so adorable. I love the bright colors of the pink on her bow, and then the pillow that she is sitting on is flocked, so that is a super cute detail as well. And the Aristocats is just one of my favorite Disney movies of all time, and so I absolutely love this ornament and always have to make sure that I have some Aristocats representation on my tree. And now that I have this one, this has become my like go-to ornament for the Christmas tree. So next up is this Tinkerbell ornament. This is from 2009, so this is a pretty old ornament at this point, but it is absolutely one of my favorites. It features Tink, and it is the scene where she is walking over the map to kind of tell them where to go. So you see like the points on the map. It has Hangman's tree and things like that. So, and then it just has some pixie dust like trailing behind her, which I think is super cute. There's her little like inky footprints, and yeah, this one is just super adorable, and I love the glitter details on her wings. I have a whole bunch of Tinkerbell Hallmark ornaments, but this is definitely one of my favorites and one that has consistently gone on my tree for the past 11 years. Next up is another Little Mermaid ornament, and this one is another Hallmark keepsake ornament. This one features Ariel with the Eric statue. I believe it plays Part of Your World. This one was from 2014, so a pretty old ornament. And it has consistently, again, gone on my tree every year since I got it. And this is just absolutely one of my favorite scenes in the movie. I love the song, and then I love when Flounder and Sebastian are able to give her the statue. And I just love how she like stares longingly at it, and it's just super awesome. And the detail on the statue is awesome. You have the little E down there, and then just like his body and everything and his face, it really does look just like the Eric statue, so it's super cool. And then Ariel is there looking super in love, and then you have the glitter details on her fins and her tail. And then let's see if this one still plays the song as well. And it does.
I wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh.
So yeah, absolutely one of my favorite ornaments for one of my favorite scenes in my favorite movie. So I think we're down to our last three ornaments now. And so first up for my last three is this other Little Mermaid ornament, of course, and it is Ariel, and it is another one of those Disney store ornaments where it is just like the full body princess with the little like dress skirt, and this is Ariel in a little Christmas outfit, and I absolutely love this pink dress and on her and the bow, and she's holding a little glittery ornament, And I just love the glitter details on the skirt and on like the bodice of her dress, and on like the fur there. So I just think that this is absolutely beautiful. This is an ornament from 2017, and again, it has gone on my tree consistently since receiving it. And yeah, I just absolutely love this one. I think Ariel looks beautiful, and the year I got this one, Disney did a whole line of all the princesses in different Christmas outfits, and so I absolutely loved that series. I have a few other ones, but Ariel is obviously my favorite, as she's my favorite princess. So I absolutely love this one. Okay, so I lied, I didn't have three more, I only have two more, and so this is the very last ornament on my list of favorites, and this is actually a set of ornaments, so it is multiple, so it might be kind of cheating to include all of them, but this is just a set that I absolutely love and is just so special to me. That when, as soon as I saw that it was releasing, I knew that I had to have it because it is just one of my favorite things and is just so cool. So it is the set of Jack Skellington ornaments, and they are from Hallmark. They were from 2018, so 2 years ago, and they are keepsake ornaments, and they are just each of like a set of nine of different of Jack's different expressions. So here is one. You have his little, like, this kind of looks like the face that he makes when he first looks at Christmas Town, and these are all like glass ornaments as well. And then you have this one of him smiling. You have this one of kind of a little angrier of a face. There is this one, which is kind of like an upset, like scared face almost. This one, which reminds me of like when he's singing the songs, like maybe like when he's singing about Santa Claus in like the town meeting song. Yeah, absolutely. This is one of my favorites from the whole set. And then there's this one, which again kind of is like a little like wondrous surprise, kind of reminds me of when he's in Christmas Town kind of face. There is this one of like a more mischievous kind of grin. This one with like the most evil smirk that I have ever seen on Jack, and I love it. And then last but not least, we have a ornament of Pumpkin King Jack. So I absolutely love this ornament set. It is so cool. Just everything about the art that went into creating The Nightmare Before Christmas is just so cool to me. I literally, so on Disney Plus, there is that series Prop Magic, or Prop Culture is what it's called, and where they just kind of like went through all the different props from different like iconic Disney movies, and they just showed some of the cast and crew these props and like reunited them with things, and they had a Nightmare Before Christmas episode, and that episode just made me sob. That movie is so special to me. It's one of my favorites. It just makes me feel so like warm and happy inside, and it's just something that like cheers me up whenever I'm down, and it is a movie that is appropriate for both of my favorite holidays of the year. So it's just so special, and I love it. And there was so much work and effort and art that went into making it. And these ornaments are just so cool to me because there are, I forget the exact number, but it is hundreds of different like heads, interchangeable heads for Jack Skellington's character that all had different facial expressions and different like eye shapes and mouths and things like that. So I think it's just so cool to have this set that is like a little snippet of all of those different heads that like they use to create Jack and his expressiveness, because I feel like for a stop motion like claymation kind of character and for like a puppet, they were able to get him to be so expressive, and especially for the fact that he is a skeleton and he's not like a humanoid kind of thing, the way that they were able to create him to just have these dramatic awesome expressions is just so cool and so special from like an artistic standpoint. So I absolutely love everything about these ornaments, and I think they do get the top spot. This list wasn't really ranked, but I think if I had to choose like a favorite ornament or ornament set of all time, it would be these, because they are just the coolest to me and just represent everything I love about Nightmare Before Christmas and the work that Tim Burton and crew put into it. So yeah, these are absolutely some favorites, and they're so pretty and just iconic and wonderful. So I absolutely love them. So yeah, that is my top 10 favorite Disney ornaments. A lot of Little Mermaid, a lot of Nightmare Before Christmas on there, but those are just some of my favorite things and things that make me think of family around the holidays, or make me just think of some of my favorite things and how special they are to me. So yeah, with that being said, on to the final day of our Funko Pocket Pop Advent Calendar. So every day of Vlogmas, I have been unboxing this Funko Pocket Pop Advent Calendar, and we are finally on to the last day, day 24. If you want to see what I have gotten for the other 23 days, I will leave my Vlogmas playlist down below so that you can check that out. There have been some pretty awesome, like, polls so far. You can see some of them behind me. But yeah, I am thinking that for day 24, we are probably going to get Santa Jack Skellington because we haven't seen him yet. We already got Sandy Claus, and I feel like it would just only be fitting to include Santa Jack in a Christmas Countdown Advent calendar. And it is Christmas Eve, after all, the day when Jack dresses as Santa and goes around trying to give gifts and make Christmas his. So I think that would just be super fitting. So let's see if my prediction is correct. So here is the advent calendar. We have opened up all of the days so far. I know that there is like this thing, like the door here, and you're supposed to like set everything down on here, but I just did not have a space where I could fit this whole box to kind of make a little display out of them. So I've been displaying them up behind me during Vlogmas. So yeah, that's how I've been doing it. So here is day 24. Let's break open this final door. It is so crazy to think that it is done and Christmas is tomorrow. This month kind of flew by. Really, like, doing Vlogmas was a lot of work and very stressful, but it also made the time go by so quickly. All right, so last bag. I'm not gonna look too closely at it because I don't want to spoil it, but I think it feels a lot like it's Santa Jack. Yep. So here we have Santa Jack Skellington. He's got his little Sandy Claus outfit and beard. He has a little present in his hands. But other than the present, he's in like the typical Jack pose where he's got his hand like that. So he is super cute. And I said I was kind of tired of the Jack variants, but I'm glad that we did get Santa Jack because that is just a classic for this season. So we absolutely needed to have him included here. So yeah, I think that it is only fitting that we get Santa Jack and that he was the one for Christmas Eve. I do have to say though, his mouth is kind of like messed up. I don't really like the way that that looks, like the lines through his mouth, they're kind of off. And then there's like big chunks of just like black, like where it looks like he was supposed to be kind of like open mouth smiling. And you're supposed to see like teeth or something. I don't know, it's weird. So that didn't really translate into mini form very well. But other than that, he is a super cute miniature version of Santa Jack, and I absolutely love him. So that brings us to the very end of Vlogmas. Thank you to anybody who has been watching along on this journey for all 24 days with me. I have had so much fun making these videos and sharing all of these Christmassy things with you, and I hope that you had just as much fun watching. Comment down below and let me know what your favorite Christmas ornament that you own is, whether it's Disney or not. I would love to hear about it. Do you have any of these same Disney ornaments that I do? I would love to know if we are ornament twins on anything, and if maybe those are ornaments that also have a special place for you as well, like they do for me. So yeah, let me know down below. I would love to talk about it. If you enjoyed this Vlogmas series and would like to see me do it next year, comment down below and let me know that, as well as if you have any suggestions for future Christmassy holiday like Vlogmas content you would like to see, so that way I have some ideas for next year of some things to do. So yeah, let me know what you thought of the advent calendar. Is there one that you think that I should unbox next year? I know Funko does a couple every year. They usually have like Harry Potter and some other things, and Lego does advent calendars, and there's like different like the Animators Collection does one from Disney. You know what advent calendar you'd like to see me unbox next year if I do Vlogmas. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching this video and for watching every other Vlogmas video if you have, or just any of the other ones that you have clicked into. My 100 subscriber giveaway is still going on until tomorrow. It will close at midnight on Christmas Day. So if you haven't already entered, that will be up above and down below so that you can go ahead and enter that for a chance to win. If you are celebrating, I hope that you have the most Merry Christmas that you can this year, even though Christmas looks a lot different for a lot of us. It's still a magical time, and whoever you spend it with and however you spend it is still going to be extremely special and wonderful. So I hope that you have a magical Christmas day. If you are celebrating, I hope you've had a magical holiday season so far. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Bye, everyone.